All right, mic test, mic test. All right, so we're heading out. Getting out of the village. Run through these woods because there's no way for me to fast travel. Must be a cutscene or something that's gonna happen. I take that back. We did have an option to fast travel. I just didn't see that warp there before. Normally, you don't see them until. Feel nothing.
Monster. He was with Melchior. There was something different about him. He wasn't a Moloch, though, right?
Yeah. I'm pretty sure he's a demon. But why would the Abbey be working with a demon?
I wouldn't bet anything that's high creed. Maybe.
I mean, there was Medissa and Kamalana.
No, I don't think so. The Abbey keeps their Therians behind barriers and bound to Earth Pulse points. A Therian can't send malevolence to Enominat while walking freely.
That's correct. And besides, Orthrus was already here.
In any case, now we know Melchior has a mean-looking bodyguard in addition to his illusions. It'll take quite a lot to stop him.
Aye. That's a fact.
Anything is eye-free.
Eleanor, there's something I have to ask.
What is it?
Did you leak our plans to the Abbey?
Eleanor hasn't done anything like that.
Then how do you explain Melchior and his illusions already waiting for us when we got to a ball?
I promised you that I would work together with you until I found the truth for myself. I'm not up to any tricks. It's far too late for that now.
Exactly what a guilty party would say.
If anyone's suspicious here, I'd say it's you, Mogilu.
No tricks. I don't even know what a trick is.
Enough. If Eleanor was leaking information, then Titania would surely be under attack by now.
Right. I'm sure the Abbey would love to have those Therians back.
But the enemy was in that village waiting in ambush.
The Abbey isn't foolish. They figured out by now that we're rounding up the Therians. They'll have left traps for us, with each remaining one. It's the obvious move.
All right. If that's how you see it, I'll stand down.
So you trust me, then?
No. I'm saying that anything the Abbey tries, I'll be ready for it.
Oh, such a brave, determined soul.
Aguilu is such an instigator.
Better watch your step!
Listen, Eleanor really isn't spying on us. I was with her almost every minute, and when I wasn't, Velvet was watching her. And she's a woman who keeps her promises. She wouldn't lie to...
Lafayette.
We understand, Lafayette. It's Eleanor. If she were lying to herself to somehow keep spying on us, the guilt would fill her with malevolence.
I see. You're right. The fact that I haven't turned into a dragon proves that.
Thank you. Both of you.
I didn't think you were giving them information intentionally.
But there are illusionists like Melchior out there. That means we can't rule out someone recording your thoughts in secret.
I don't think we need to worry about that either. Not with you and Lafayette always near.
Now that that's settled, it's time for you all to testify to my innocence.
That could be difficult.
What?
Well, okay. Why don't you start off by telling us all about the time you sold us out to Teresa back in Hellevise?
Oh, why bring up that old yam? You're a very vindictive man, do you know that?
You're just figuring that out? Well, there's your proof, at least. You wouldn't make much of a spy.
She really wouldn't.
Hey, that's not what I meant! You were mean!
Find a tavern. ability to have magic. Where the hell is that town? Is it Rome? That's a card game, I don't want that. At least got an arcane battle out of it. Here we go.
Welcome back.
Yeah.
Dogs? Look, lizards, no problem. Walking hunks of armor I can deal with, but dogs? On my ship?
You're not a dog person.
I was, bit by one when I...
Then you've got nothing to worry about. If they're biting anyone on this ship...
Are you okay, Velvet?
Oh, sure. They're just dogs.
No, I mean, in general. Fine. They can come aboard. I'll take us back to Titania.
I devoured them again. No, don't.
So, you said your little brother made this copy. He could read the ancient tongue. That's amazing.
Luffy was different from most other kids. He read books a lot because his body was so weak. He studied all the time, so that he could be ready to travel the world one day. Which was kind of funny, considering he'd hide in my bed whenever he had a nightmare.
Really?
But I don't care that he got scared. I just wanted him to live. That's why I have to...
Velvet!
I'll devour as much as it takes. I will have vengeance.
Velvet!
Done. The art is attuned to you.
Thank you. This time I'll make sure to finish what I set out to do.
I've gotta say, I didn't think you had it in you, Oscar.
I don't believe I asked for your opinion.
Lord Artorias!
Go back outside, Teresa. We'll see you when we're done.
Are the rumors true? Are you using that experimental art on Oscar?
It is true.
I was under the impression it was still incomplete, sir.
Yep. Still a potentially fatal weakness for its channeler.
We've taken the theory as far as it will go. The next step is to learn its control and actual practice.
Don't tell me you intend to test it against that Therian! Please, let me do it. I should be the one, not him!
You are not strong enough.
Then at least let me back him up!
So you can take the enemy out before Oscar uses the art? A noble plan, but I'm afraid it'd mess everything up.
So,
it was my idea to volunteer, sister. I failed at Titania and allowed the Therian to be stolen from Palamedes. I need to atone for my mistakes.
Then let me come with you.
I have different orders for you. Teresa Linares, you are hereby relieved of your duties as an exorcist and are to return your monarch.
Relieved of duty? Why?
For our plans to be realized, we require an especially strong Moloch. We've analyzed your Moloch's dormant abilities, and he is of considerable power, on the same level as the young Moloch who betrayed us for the enemy.
Simply put, you just don't got what it takes to handle him, sweetheart.
When this is all over, I'd love to have some of your homemade cooking again, sister. I could go for that quiche you used to make.
How can you talk of that right now?
Lord Artorias.
I know what you're going to ask. Yes, Oscar, when you fulfill your mission, I will make Teresa an exorcist again.
Oscar, are you doing this for...
Don't worry about me. I'd go to the ends of the earth and back for a plate of your delicious quiche.
What should I do? If I don't do something, he'll... Huh? What's this? I'm receptive to that art. And to you.
Where am I?
Take it easy, Velvet. You've been out for 3 days.
Then that's 3 days wasted. What's the situation?
Well, let's see. For one thing, Grimoire's been deciphering that ancient book. She says that this new copy is complete. All the pages we were missing are there. As for the dogs, Kamoana's taken a real shine to them.
All right, then. Now we just need to find that last Therian.
Velvet, no! I said take it easy. Seriously.
Oh, hold on. Have you not had anything to eat?
Well, I just thought, since you hadn't either.
Are you serious? Why would you do a full thing like that? You'll die if you don't eat.
Actually, he won't die if he doesn't eat. Malakim don't actually depend on food for sustenance. If they do eat, it's only as a quirky hobby.
All right, if you're sure. If you feel like going hungry, it's your life. But there's no sense in doing it on my account.
Good to see you're feeling better again. As you probably noticed, we made it back to Titania already.
Sorry to keep you all waiting on me. Get everyone together. We meet now.
Well, that could have gone better.
I just wanted to better understand the hardships Velvet's suffering through. It seems unfair for her to bear all of it alone.
Well, she's... how can I put it? A very straightforward kind of person.
But nothing gets under her skin like a clumsy display of sympathy.
What should I do about her then?
For now, just get something in your tummy. Any good warrior knows you eat when you have the chance. Even Malakim have more strength on a full stomach than an empty one, don't they?
Yeah.
It's true. Food will fill an empty stomach. But what is there to fill an empty heart, I wonder?
Okay, Fi. I need you to find us our next Earth Pulse point.
I found one, but it's really, really far. Way up in the northeast.
If it's that far out, it has to be an Engand.
Engand is a collection of small islands. There's a comparatively bigger one called Lionel Island, but that's the exception.
Yeah, I think the Earth Pulse point's probably out there.
Engand, huh? Those waters are haunted by ghost ships, you know.
Ghost ships?
Yep. Legend has it they snatch up wrongdoers who bear lingering regrets and whisk them away to that eternal voyage.
That doesn't sound promising.
Currents from all over the world converge in Engand's waters, so a lot of shipwrecks from distant seas end up there as their final resting place.
So that's where the stories of ghost ships come from.
Boo! You guys have no imagination.
I'd rather they stay imaginary myself.
We should still be careful.
We'll be fine. Ghost ship, exorcist, whatever comes along. We'll be the ones to administer their last rites.
Oh. Oh.
Aw, come on! It's fine!
No, it's not. You have to do it right.
You're so mean, Medissa! If you keep telling me what to do, I'll hate you!
Fine. Hate me then. So long as you do what I say.
Fine! I love you, Medissa, and you don't even care!
What's going on here?
Eleanor! Medissa's being mean! She keeps telling me to dry my hair after my bath, but I don't wanna!
What? Is that all you're arguing about?
This is important. Just because she's a Therian doesn't mean she can't catch a cold.
But I won't! I won't catch a cold! I swear! I don't want to take Mom's yucky, awful medicine, so I'm not gonna get sick!
If you insist on being so stubborn, we can do this the hard way.
There's no need for everyone to get so worked up. Her hair's pretty much dry already, right?
Yeah, what she said!
I'm spoiling her, aren't I?
Seriously. Look, we don't even know what would happen if a Therian catches a cold, let alone how to treat it.
That's true.
But look, I get it. I know you feel responsible for her.
You mean what happened to her mother?
Yeah. Lafayette told me about it.
My, my. Look who's a little tattletale.
I'm sorry. But I thought Medissa should know, just in case.
It's fine, I suppose. I should have told her myself.
Well, at least I understand everything now. It's all too tragic for words.
Yes. And the knowledge would not be something that a young child could possibly bear. I'm not planning on telling her.
That's probably your only option. But do you really think you can keep lying to her forever?
I have to. For her own sake.
For her, huh?
All right. I'll go with you on this.
You two are going through an awful lot of trouble for a selfish kid.
All kids are selfish. They're selfish. But that's what their families and their mothers should be there for. Don't you have any memories like that yourself?
Sorry, but I'd rather just keep them to myself.
Pish and piffle. Everybody and their issues, am I right?
Coming up on Lionel Island.
So much for the ghost ships.
Should we expect another welcome party waiting for us again?
No. I had the Bloodwings spread a rumor that we were raiding an Abbey compound far, far from here.
As far as plans go, that's better than nothing.
All this cloak and dagger. Give me a good old frontal assault any day.
First mate, sir. There's a ship drifting ahead of us.
A ghost ship?
It's an Abbey ship. Their flag. It's a distress signal.
Understood. Commence approach.
Are you actually going to help an enemy ship?
A ship signaling distress has neither allies nor enemies. That's a code all seafarers abide by.
It's an obvious trap.
Not even pirates would use a distress signal for a surprise attack. Of course, after we rescue a ship, we still strip them of everything they've got.
Anyway, if it's a trap, we'll kill everyone on board. Simple.
A waste of time if you ask me.
Oh, let's beat him up.
Is this the Corsair Scourge?
Benwick, do we still have any Salatoma left?
Yes, sir. If this is their full crew, we should have enough on board to treat them.
Now that you mention it, don't Abbey ships usually have a bigger crew?
These were all who were aboard when I hijacked the ship and made them set sail.
Teresa!
I knew I was being reckless, but I never expected we'd run afoul of the Corsair's Scourge. But you know, I'm glad we did, since it brought me to you.
You seriously plan to fight in that condition?
No, no. I know you've won this one. Use me as you will.
Use you?
Don't bother asking. It's a trap.
Lionel Island is where you'll find Dees. Hetherian. My brother Oscar is guarding over it.
We can handle him just fine.
You should know that Oscar's acquired a powerful new art. Its formula developed by Lord Melchior. The art heightens a Moloch's power far beyond its normal limits. The effect is incredible. Normal arts don't even compare. Even were you to win, you wouldn't come away unscathed.
Why are you telling us this?
The art is still untested and imperfect. There's no guarantee its caster will survive the effects. I don't want anything to happen to Oscar. If I'm your hostage, Oscar won't move against you. This will afford you a window to snatch the Therian and make your escape.
You're willing to betray the Abbey?
There's nothing in this world that could ever replace Oscar. I know you can't trust me, so don't give me your medicine. Place my life in your hands. Just save Oscar.
Lady Teresa!
If true, this information will be of use to us. For now, let's bring her aboard and give her the medicine.
I gotta turn this all the way up.
So, you're going to believe her story?
An art that boosts a Moloch's power far beyond its normal limits. Sounds like we might be in for a real fight.
And she said that Melchior developed it, too.
Maybe this explains why he was so intent on acquiring that Siegfried relic.
If this is all true, a frontal assault might not be the best idea.
But why do you think Teresa is willing to go so far to protect Oscar?
Oscar is the second son of the Dragonia family. Aristocrats with ancestral ties to the Asgard royal lineage. From what I understand, he was sent to the Abbey in the hopes of strengthening his family's ties to the group.
For the good of the bloodline. Happens all the time.
Teresa followed him to the Abbey, where she's been his constant savior, even if she's kept it from him.
So she's another noble too. Could have had an easy life if she'd just kept in her place.
No, Teresa was conceived, outside of formal matrimony, and her mother was not of what you call high standing.
Ah, so her mother was a hoe.
It happens more often than you might think.
Her mother was a whore.
My mother died. And my father's wife never cared for me. So I merely served the Dragonia family as a maid. Those were dark, lonely times for me.
My mother was a hoe.
But Oscar. Oscar was the only one who called me his sister and embraced me as family.
Poor mother.
Did sister need any other reason to want to save her brother?
She's literally the daughter of a bitch.
So you're back on your feet.
Literally.
My sincere thanks for the medicine.
I can't use you as a hostage if you're dead. Where's the Therian?
Over that way.
Ahead through the Baird Marsh are the ruins of an ancient kingdom. There you'll find the Earth Pulse Point, along with Oscar.
What happened to number one?
Lord Artorias took number one away from me. As it stands, I'm without the powers of an exorcist. As such, whether I live or die is for you people to decide. Once Oscar is safe, you can do whatever you like to me.
We'll do as you wish. All of it. I know you know this, Fee.
He's offering.
Don't let your guard down for one second.
I won't.
I mean, you know, since she's offering, I mean, you know, it really kind of look, you know what, never mind, I don't want to get any ideas. because she did say, you know, anything we wish, I'm just, you know, I don't want to be that guy, but she is kind of cute, so, yeah, I'll shut up now.
Teresa, it's been a while.
We haven't seen each other since the throne. But that doesn't seem like so long ago to me. Not when I keep hearing so much about you. Eleanor Hume, the traitor.
What of the Corsair Scourge?
Nothing to worry about. I've had my dose of Solitoma.
Was it as bad as you remembered it? Brings you back to when you were an initiate, doesn't it?
Why did you betray us, Eleanor? When the Abbey made you a patrolling inspector, they placed great responsibility upon you.
What are we doing our bidding right now?
Take on that role. He had already been selected for it.
Last thing you should be doing is worrying about why somebody betrayed.
That sweet, naive man that he is. He let you take it.
I had no idea. Oscar had already been chosen?
Yes. And after he passed on it, he was stationed on that dangerous island where he sustained that awful wound. And now, you accompany the monster that nearly killed him. I feel I have a right to some answers.
My desire to save humanity has not changed. I have simply found a path different from the Abbey's.
I don't find that answer acceptable.
I didn't think that you would. I know very well that you offer no compromises when it comes to Oscar.
You're right. I don't. Be sure to inform your new friends of that fact. In order for me to protect Oscar, I'm going to need you all to trust me. That's all I have to say to you.
I understand.
You realize your life is in my hands right now, right? Just throwing it out there. Why do I have a feeling that we needed to change that? You know what? Let me change this. Thank you.
We will need to be extremely narrow.
Really? Dude, I'm... Life bottles. I didn't buy any damn life bottles.
We will need to be extremely rare.
Oh, cool. Thank you. How much money do I have? My goal. I should go back and get some life bottles before I regret it. Hey man, haven't we been here before? I think we have. Yeah, we were here before, because I remember that arc.
Thank you.
Alright, you both gotta go.
Power number two displayed at the throne. Hard to believe he had that hidden in him. Lord Melchior said that number one was full of untapped potential as well. If I have the talent to use it.
Teresa, my lady, you seem angry.
Me? At what?
At me, for running away and joining Velvet.
Oh, that? I was careless. An enemy stole a tool of mine. I'm merely frustrated at my own incompetence.
A tool.
I don't care what happens to me now. Not as long as I can save Oscar.
I'm the one who hurt your precious brother. And you're asking for my help now?
Yes, you hurt him. You scarred his face, and his honor, and his heart.
Still holding a grudge then? Well, at least you won't be able to kill me in my sleep.
With no Malakim, I'm an ordinary woman. How could I threaten the Lord of Calamity? I'm painfully aware of my own weakness.
Good. Try to keep out of the way, then.
Lady Teresa, Velvet isn't so different from you. She had a little brother, she...
I know all about the Lord of Calamity.